You're watching the Morning News on 10. Today is World Mental Health Day, and according to latest statistics, that makes it a very important day for up to 600,000 Australians. That's the number of us affected by things like depression, schizophrenia and anxiety disorders. Well over $6 billion was spent last year on mental health-related services. The most troubling fact, though, is that half of those affected by mental illness are missing out on treatment. David Meldrum is from the Mental Illness Fellowship of Australia, and he's in our Canberra studios for us this morning. David, why are so many people missing out on treatment for mental illness?
Partly because they don't know where to find them. I mean, there are actual gaps in services. There are gaps in medical and clinical and housing and employment services for people with mental illness, particularly serious mental illness like schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. But that's only part of the problem. A big part of the problem is we don't market well. They don't know where to find us. We constantly hear the story from people, why didn't I know about you years ago?
600,000 Australians affected by these illnesses seems like a huge number. Is there an increase in mental health illnesses generally, or are we just becoming more aware of them?
I think we're becoming more aware of them. There may be some spikes here and there, but in general, these are not uncommon figures for any developed country.
Now, it's been a taboo issue for so long. Are many people suffering things like bipolar and depression still being marginalised in society?
Absolutely. It's still a very difficult decision whether to tell your boss or your friends or your landlord that you have a mental illness. Mm. There are too many bad stories out there. That's changing, and it's changing for the better quite rapidly, I think, but there is still a lot of stigma about.
There seems to be a huge cost to the community in dealing with mental health issues. We mentioned a figure there of $6 million in treatment in 1 year alone. But the cost of not dealing with it would seem to be even greater.
Absolutely. You've got people with psychotic illnesses, for example, of whom there are several hundred thousand, have an 80% unemployment rate. So that's an awful lot of people who are not in the productive labour force paying taxes.
Now, as part of Mental Health Day, you're actually launching a new initiative called My Networks. How does that work and who is it directed at?
It's directed at people at the time, whether they are a person with an illness or a family member or a friend, a brother or a sister, who want to know more about what this illness is, about where I can find help, not just medical help and clinical help, but also the community supports, the accommodation, the employment opportunities that they want to follow up. We all in the non-government sector particularly do those things and do them pretty well. But we don't market it well. So we're saying, here's a logo, here's a badge, here's a national 1800 number, here's a website. If you go to a place with those things on it, you're guaranteed a good service from people who know what they're talking about, particularly with serious mental illness.
All right, David, thank you very much for having a chat to us this morning. David Meldrum from the Mental Illness Fellowship of Australia.